Now, whether it's the struggle to get on the property ladder or the cost of university education, the financial pressures facing young people continue to rise, which means the generational wealth gap therefore also widens. A report has suggested 25-year-olds should get a £10,000 payment from the state and some pensioners should be taxed more. The Resolution Foundation says the contract between young and old has broken down. Here's our economics correspondent, Andy Verity. A man's been jailed at Preston Crown Court for a minimum of 26 years for committing a murder and then trying to get his teenage son to take the blame. Now, the trial is continuing of an army sergeant accused of trying to kill his wife by tampering with her parachute. Emil Siliers denies attempted murder and criminal damage. Our correspondent Duncan Kakew. Lawyers representing Sir Cliff Richard say the singer might have suffered permanent damage to his self-esteem as a result of BBC coverage of a police search of his home in 2014. Sir Cliff, who was never arrested or charged, is suing the corporation for what he says was a serious invasion of privacy. Our correspondent Helena Lee. 2,000 people have now been forced from their homes in Hawaii as the Kilauea volcano continues to erupt, destroying dozens of homes. Officials on the island say they are particularly concerned. A store of natural gas at a power plant is now under threat from the lava flow. Caroline Davies reports. Now, Mark Williams has claimed his third world snooker title 15 years after his last. The Welshman beat John Higgins from Scotland in a dramatic final in Sheffield. Our sports correspondent Andy Swiss reports. All right, let's turn to our next story. I'm trying to do a segue, but I'm not going to. I don't usually mind spiders, but if you're not keen, I would look away now because this might test you. Scientists in Manchester say they've made a huge leap in robotics after studying this spider, the regal jumping spider. This one, nicknamed Kim. Well, Kim can leap six times her body length from a standing start, and experts say their studies of her could help design a new generation of robots. If you can bear to look, our science reporter Helen Briggs explains. Let's take you to the weather with Darren. Hi.
Yes, moving swiftly on.
Darren, thank you very much. That's all from us then on the BBC News at 1. Goodbye. On BBC One, we'll join the news teams where you are. Have a good afternoon. Bye-bye.